Hello friends, in my this video I am going to discuss about diagonal matrix, okay, which is very important. And in MATLAB you may find the inbuilt function to create diagonal matrix, okay. But if you use that, then what is that? Already something is made and you are using that, so we will not going to use that inbuilt function. Rather we will create our own diagonal matrix using the programming concept and using our logic, okay. So see, the question is create a diagonal matrix in MATLAB, and same program I will show you for Java also. So see, what is diagonal matrix? A square matrix is a diagonal matrix if all values that are not on diagonal are zero, okay. Already these things you have studied in detail in your joint entrance examination or in your higher secondary mathematics courses, right? So there is nothing new. We all know what is diagonal matrix, and mathematically also we know that we can represent like this: a of ij equal to 0 for I equal to I not equal to j, basically for I not equal to j. Let me write this a of ij for I not equal to j. So not equal to I have given this symbol like we give for MATLAB, okay. So like here you just consider this particular diagonal matrix 4 9 5. Only diagonal elements are here present, and rest of these, apart from the main body diagonal, see all the numbers are zeros. It may happen that diagonal elements are also zeros, one or two element or all element, but that is not our point of interest. Our point of interest is apart from the main diagonal or body diagonal, rest all are zeros or not. See, so it is happening here, a of ij equal to 0 for I not equal to j. So this is called diagonal matrix, and obviously it has to be one square matrix. So how to write a MATLAB program to create one diagonal matrix? See, first obviously from the user we have to take the diagonal elements at least, right? So basically we will take the input from the user, the diagonal elements, and we will use two nested for loops as we use for 2D array or matrix. Then we will check whether I equal to j or not. If I equal to j, we will insert one by one elements of the array given by the user. Otherwise we will use zero. We will put zero, okay. That is the simple concept. Let us directly go to MATLAB. See, obviously in the beginning you can write CLC, clear all, close all. You can write warning off also. So v equal to input, enter the array for the diagonal elements. Then we are defining one empty array y. Then we are defining one counter k equal to 1. See what is the application of this latter, I will explain. Now see, here I have used two for loops. This is nested for loop used for matrix or 2D array, as we use for other programming language too, like C, C++, Java, Python, etc. Now for I equal to 1 colon length of V, that is the input. Suppose there are 3 inputs, so 3 cross 3 matrix will be created. Suppose there are 5 inputs given by the user, then 5 cross 5 matrix will be created, okay. So I equal to 1 colon length of V for J equal to 1 colon length of V. I is there for the rows and J is there for the columns. If I equal to j, that means there is diagonal element, in that case y of ij equal to v of k. So that I have defined here the counter value as 1, because in MATLAB array index starts from 1. So y of 1 1, suppose I equal to 1, j equal to 1, y of y 1 1 is equal to v of 1. Then we are incrementing the counter, so k equal to k plus 1. Else, if I not equal to j, then y of ij equal to what? 0, as we have just seen. Now end this for if else. In this for internal for, in this for external for, okay. And display y to display that. Let us check whether our this particular program works or not. So control A, evaluate selection, enter the array. Suppose let me give 2 3. Now see here, one diagonal matrix, square matrix is created, which is diagonal matrix, and diagonal elements are 2 3. Now let us check for 1 5 6 4 7 9. I have given randomly. See, you write and click enter. See, diagonal elements are 1, 5, 6, 4, 7, 9, and rest all for I not equal to j, it is 0. So it is easily creating diagonal matrix, okay. So what we can do now, we can implement the same program in Java, How? See, same algorithm I have used, just syntax different. So first we have to take one array input. So what we have to do? First we have to take the input in Java. Either you can use scanner class or buffer reader class. So input java.util.scanner plus kaku, then public static void main string args. Then we are creating the object in the scanner class. So scanner obj equal to new scanner system.in. Then system.out.println enter the array length. Okay, in MATLAB we no need to take that. MATLAB will dynamically arrange its space. But in Java, if you want to use dynamically input, then you should go through linked list, but which is a bit difficult concept. You should have a clear idea in data structures. So I have used arrays only. So int l equal to obj.next in. Then int a equal to new int l. We have created one array of length l. Then for int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus, a of I equal to obj.next in. In this way, we are taking input from the user in the array. Then we have to make one square matrix. Diagonal matrix is square matrix. So int y equal to new int l l. Okay, that is row l, l cross l matrix is created. Then int k l equal to 0. Here we have defined counter k equal to 1, because in MATLAB array index start from 1, but in Java array index start from 0. So we have defined k l equal to 0. Then observe this particular part. This part is exactly, sorry, this particular part is exactly same like whatever we have written in MATLAB. For int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus. For int j equal to 0, j less than l, j plus plus is nothing but for I equal to 1 colon length of v, for j equal to 1 colon length of v. Okay, there's differences in MATLAB array index start from 1, so loop will go from 1 to length of v, but in Java array index start from 0, so it will go from 0 to length of v minus 1, you can say. If I equal to j, y of ij equal to a of kl, kl equal to kl plus 1, else y of ij equal to 0. Okay, with proper bracket closing, we can just print this using this part. For int I equal to 0, I less than l, I plus plus. For int j equal to 0, j less than l, j plus plus. System.out.print y of ij, then one space. This is to print in a same line. Then we are using println to go to make the cursor to the next line. Okay. That's all. Let us check whether our code is working or not. Go to CMD, then CD Java, then Java C, KAKU dot Java, then Java KAKU. See, enter the total bill. Sorry. KAKU. Okay. Oh, sorry. Here I have written the wrong class name. Sorry. CMD CD Java Java C K U K A. Kuka was our class name. Then Java K U K A. So enter the array length. Suppose let us give 5. So now enter the element. Suppose 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. See, one matrix is created whose diagonals are 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Rest all are zeros. One more application let us check. Suppose let me give 0, 4, sorry, array length I have given as 0. Let me simulate it again. Suppose array length is 4, then first element 0, second element 1, third element 2, and fourth element 3. So see, here then diagonal 0, 1, 2, 3 is there, and rest all are zeros. So this Java code is perfectly working too. So this is all for my this video. If you understand it clearly, you can implement in any programming language. Try to understand the algorithm. Okay, if you are unable to note down the whole program, I'll post a link in the description where you can check. You will get the two programs also. Okay, thank you for watching.